Soil is the foundation for profitable, productive, and environmentally sound agricultural systems. By understanding how the soil processes that support plant growth and regulate environmental quality are affected by management practices, it is possible to design a crop and soil management system that improves and maintains soil health over time. Food Friday this week looks at how maize farmers in Western Kenya are growing their yields through soil nutrition.
Soil is an essential part of food production, but years of degradation, poor agricultural practices, heavy fertilizer use and chemical use have not only stripped the soil of fertility but also turned it too acidic to sustain crops. This declining agricultural productivity has been a growing concern among farmers as the shrinking harvests affect the country's food security. A lot of explanations have been given for this declining productivity, including loss of soil fertility.
If you compare Kenya maize production and the East African, I want to start there. Our maize production has been declining on an average, and the yield average, national average, is around less than actually a ton a hectare of maize. Why is this happening? Is because the farmers were not getting enough inputs and correct inputs.
In light of the declining yields, the Ministry of Agriculture in 2019 published a report on the status of soils, specifically for suitability of maize production. The results were worrying and called for drastic changes in fertilizer use.
It gave us a picture of what is missing in the soils, what needs to be done. Based on that report, you could clearly see there are key nutrients that are missing. First of all is sulfur, key one is boron, there is also zinc, and those are actually three key primary nutrients for cereal crops.
And while most of the developing world has used fertilizer to fix its fertility problems, in Kenya, that same fertilizer has been cited as part of the problem because many of the blends are outdated and not soil specific.
Nilikuwa napata magunia kuanzia 18 hadi 20. Mwaka jana nilijaribu mbolea ya Yara. Ilitoa mimi kutoka ile magunia yenye nilikuwa napata ya chini hadi 42. Mwaka huu natarajia kupata 45.
They've been able to move from less than that, less than 10 bags an acre of 90 kg bags to more than 20 bags per acre. So that is the first step solution. We are farmers who are commercial level. So those farmers have been averaging around 20 bags of maize per acre. Now we have given them a solution and they are producing now more than 40 bags.
Where we are today here is also the farmer has embraced conservation agriculture. This is a technology that helps the farmer to produce maximally at a reduced cost and also conserves environment.
Kiangalia hapa penye nimesimama, haya mahindi matawi yangali green. Na bila yangali green hivi, mahindi tayari yameshakomaa. Unazotumia hii matawi kutoa kwenye mahindi na uopee iwe chakula ya ng'ombe.
For Kenya and most of sub-Saharan Africa, fertilizer use is low at an average of 8 kilos per hectare compared to 50 kilos in the developed world.
We advise farmers to use 75 kg at planting. That is in between per hill, 10 grams.
For the farmers in Kakamega, Yara says it has put them on a digital platform in order to reach as many of them as possible.
A farmer can have different nutritional programs through that app, and he can do comfortably different crops using that app because you already have the knowledge. From next month, we are having a specific program for maize farmers. So it will be very easy for us to reach specifically maize farmers and help them through the journey. And it also even helps the farmer to know, I have harvested this crop, where will I sell it?
So far, at least 1 million farmers are registered on the platform. Zainab Wandati, NTV, for Food Friday.